Hi, I'm Danielle Matias at Caring Medical, talking today about hip bursitis. This is the hip joint. We're looking at the front of the hip joint here. These are all the ligaments, again, soft tissue that connect bone to bone that hold your hip, that ball and socket joint together. And then we've got some muscles and tendons that attach around. Right in here, you have what's called the trochanteric bursa, which is the one that is typically talked about with hip bursitis. The bursa here, as they are with all joints of your body, it's just a small fluid-filled sac whose goal or whose purpose is to decrease friction between the layers of tissue. So between bone and tendon, where that muscle attaches to the bone, that bursa sits there just so that tendon doesn't, you know, get irritated or whatnot as it crosses over the bone. When bursa become inflamed, like they swell, they get irritated, they can be very painful. And in some cases, you know, if somebody maybe falls on their hip or they're unconditioned, but they start this crazy workout routine, you can get what's called acute hip bursitis, where most of the time you can barely walk. It's pretty miserable. You're hard to sleep. Again, patients may not even be able to walk or lay on that side. And usually acute bursitis can take care of itself with rest, ice, you know, and more kind of traditional treatments. Ultrasound studies have routinely showed that patients that are diagnosed with quote unquote chronic bursitis actually don't have really true bursitis at all, but instead have degeneration of these glute tendons as they attach on the side of the hip. So in studies, they've actually taken patients that have been diagnosed with hip bursitis, 9 out of 10 of them, so 90% of those patients with that diagnosis actually do not have hip bursitis. They have degeneration of those gluteal tendons. So in cases like that, where there's not actually even a true bursitis at all, those patients with tendon degeneration or even ligament injury, you know, that goes hand in hand, often do really well with Prolotherapy or PRP, which is platelet-rich plasma, or a combination of both, injected into those injuries to get them to heal, get them to grow new healthy tissue, and get rid of pain. Even with that, if there is still some bursa irritation from the tendon or the ligament injury, healing those tendons, healing those ligaments with Prolotherapy or PRP or a combination can actually get the pressure off that bursa and allow it to heal itself as well.